Number five, Melissa Lee.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. My question is to the Minister for Social Development and asks, what recent reports has she received about the government's youth service initiative?
Mr. Speaker.
Honourable Paula Bennett.
Mr. Speaker, youth services, which is about reaching out early to young people on or at risk of going on a benefit and engaging them in educational training, is already producing great results. The latest evaluation report shows 4 out of 5 young people enrolled in youth service are now in educational training. 63% of 16 and 17-year-olds on the youth payment achieved NCEA credits in their first year in the youth service, compared to just 24% of young people who are on the old independent youth benefit. 14% of those on youth payment achieved NCEA level 2, compared to 5% before youth services. Achieving NCEA level 2, of course, makes someone far more likely to be able to support themselves and be financially independent.
Supplementary question, Melissa Lee.
To the Minister, what evidence has she seen that youth service is working to stop young people become dependent on the benefit in the long term?
Mr. Speaker.
Honourable Paula Bennett.
It is early days, but I'm pleased we are already seeing a drop in the number of young people on the youth payment who go on to a main benefit when they turn 18. 70% of young people on the youth payment didn't go on to a main benefit when they turned 18 in the year to March 2014. And these are young people who have often come from very difficult backgrounds, wrapping support around them early and ensuring that they are not on a lifetime of welfare is what our youth services are all about.
Question number 6, Catherine Delahunty.
Tēnā koe, Mr. Speaker. He mihi nui ki te wiki o te reo Māori. He mihi nui ki te reo Māori, te reo rangatira o Aotearoa. To the